The bird was busted. She buried her nose in no man's land a half mile due west of where I went down. Wilson, the poor sap, didn't make it out. But that was his bad luck. I had more pressing problems.
Was für ein Haufen Scheiße. Das habe ich nicht verdient.
I'm just gonna say I've had plenty of practice moving quietly. Out the back of bars, bedroom windows, you don't need the details. Anyway, once those Germans were gone, I put my skills to work, heading west towards the British front, quiet as an alley cat. Between me and the British front were German trenches and German guns. Oh, and half the population of Berlin, all spoiling for a fight. Lucky day. The Brits must have been sitting down for tea and crumpets instead of shelling the Germans. Still, I had to get through to our side of the line before those guns started up again.
Passiert nicht. Klingt komisch, oder? Was gehört?
Those trenches were packed full of the Kaiser's finest. But hopefully, most of them would be looking for trouble coming the other way. Hopefully.
Was zum Teufel ist mit deinen Augen los? Patrouille, Patrouille, Patrouille. Das nervt langsam.
Voraus! Ah! Gefallen! Ah! Gefallen!
dozen German machine guns at my back kinda encouraged me to keep my head down. No Man's Land was a maze of barbed wire, dead bodies, and debris. But I held my course. Did anything survive the crash that might be useful?
George Rackham, are you? Son of the fourth bloody Earl of Windsor. How naive do you think I am? Oh.
Let's get out of here.
Much time to get him back alive.
Really bloody hurt.
Push it. Jerry raiding party.
The Germans aren't really known for giving up. They did everything they could to catch us. Wilson said I was a no-good, lying son of a bitch. I brought him home because I think he's probably right. And I hate that fact more than I can tell you.
Hearing that name through no man's land? This guy's a bloody hero.
No, he's nothing of the sort. He's a cheat, a thief, and a liar. And he'll answer for his crimes. That's right, Blackburn.
Off to the farm, are you?
I'm gonna speak up for you, you know, at the court martial. It might do you some
good.
I doubt
it, but thanks.
Wilson, with me. I need a gunner.
Over here. I'll do it. Bracken, let me help.
You don't deserve to fly.
Wilson, if I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die up there.
Come on, let's do this.
You sure you don't want to sit this one out?
Not a chance. You owe me a bloody medal.
All right, I got this. Are you with me?
Of course I'm bloody with you! Fighters on their way! I'll cover our tail!
Thank you. They're firing at us from everywhere.
Don't stay out here. Keep moving. I see him. He's over there.
That's the guy.
German on this damn balloon's gonna hear you.
Story. A selfish man who risked his own life to save another, and in doing so, found he was saved himself. Things get mixed up in wartime, though, and you'll probably hear other versions. A rogue pilot who stole a plane, who killed his buddy, then lied, cheated, and murdered his way across half the Western Front, only to escape court-martial in the chaos of an air raid. But don't listen to any of that. What you heard from me is the truth. I wouldn't tell you if it wasn't. Would I?
Was affected by the war. Every corner of the world was touched.
The human spirit drove us to fight where no one had dared to go before. Whether it was the mountains of the Alps or the skies above, we found a way. They said this would be the war to end all wars. But I wonder if there will ever be an end to human ambition and our will to destroy.
Are you all right? We're ready for you to cut the cake. Wow, these are incredible.
Yes, it was an incredible time.
You looked very handsome in that uniform.
That's not me, that's Matteo.
Oh, of course. I'm sorry, Dad. Take as long as you need.
No, no, it's okay, tesoro. It's time I told you what happened to him. It was during our last battle together, just a few days after our 21st birthday. My brother's battalion had been ordered to capture a fort deep into enemy territory. I wasn't going with him. I was part of a special unit with a different mission. Our task was to support Matteo's battalion. We were a proud unit. We changed the war for Italy. The Arditi. Forward. I had to fight up the mountain and take out anything targeting his unit.
Just hearing this story makes me worry for you.
Don't worry. I was in a full suit of armor. Besides, the Arditi were proud volunteers. We would have done anything for Italy. A church was sitting at the base of the path. Enemy troops had fortified it. I had to fight them first. that was left after the flame troops were some foot soldiers. After that, the church would be ours. There was an artillery gun that was shelling us and Mateo's unit. I had to destroy it.
And he was still heading to the fort?
Right. I had to make sure he got there. Italian offensive was in danger as long as that artillery gun remained, so I had to take it down. sure that my men were safe was to blow up the gun itself. Was one of the sweetest sights of the war for me. But there was no rest. I could see an anti-aircraft gun over the next ridge that was taking out our planes, and that was my next target.
Quel cannone antiaereo sta abbattendo i nostri bombardieri!
Carica!
Non facciamoci sorprendere sul fianco!
The gun was manned by Austro-Hungarian troops. I had to remove them before I could use the gun myself.
Man, but then I hear a noise that I will never forget. They were targeting Mateo's unit below me, so I do the only thing I can.
It was me against an entire enemy bomber squadron. If those men were killed, our advance would be completely halted, and I would have lost Mateo. After the first few went down, they started targeting me. I had to stand my ground. Thank you. nothing could dent it. But then the planes veered away. When I got up, I thought I had died and gone to hell. They blew up the mountain. They buried us. They buried themselves.
Oh God, Mateo.
I had to find him. So I went down into that hell. It was my only choice. I had to find Mateo. He could have been anywhere. Started with the first thing that came through the fog. There were allies pinned inside lodges. I needed to save them. Before we saw them. Armored vehicles coming from the enemy fort.
But you didn't have your equipment anymore.
There were crates of enemy weapons in the lodges that we scavenged and prepared ourselves with. Through sheer force of will, we took out their firepower. The lodges were safe, and I had to move on.
You never said, was Mateo in those lodges?
The men said his unit had made it further up. Mateo wasn't there. I still think about that field. Every day. Mateo had escaped. And then...
No! No!
He never got older. And here I am, still. Who decides such things? Buon compleanno, Matteo.